Hello students, myself Shivli Chakraborty, Assistant Professor Department of IT Asansol Engineering College and our subject Computer Organization. This is our 14th class. In last class, that is in class 13, we learnt about hardware multiplication method. And in this class, we'll be learning Booth's multiplication method. The hardware multiplication method that we learnt, that is directly dealing with the numbers and it is not considered there to get the sign of the number. What we did in the resultant bit, the sign was decided by the sign of the multiplicand and multiplier bit. And in hardware multiplication method, we followed the XOR operation for the sign bit for both multiplicand and multiplier to set the sign bit for the result AS. So separately, we need to think about the sign of the number. But in case of Booth's multiplication method, as it gives a procedure for multiplying binary integer in sign 2's complement representation, the multiplication process itself takes care about the sign of the number. So it's a procedure for multiplying binary integer in sign 2's complement representation. What happens? The string of zeros in the multiplier require no addition but just shifting. We have seen in hardware multiplication method too. When we were having a string of multiplier bit, when we were having a string of multiplier bit like 0, 0, 0, let us suppose 1, 1, 1, 1, again 0. So when we were having a string of 0, have we done any addition operation? No. But when we were having a 1 in the multiplier bit, what we did, the multiplicand is added with the partial product. And then after, it got right shifted. But when there is 0 only, multiplicand is not added. Only we have, and only the number, the partial result has to be right shifted to get the answer. So each time when there is a 1, we are doing addition plus right shift. When there is a 0, we have only done right shift. But in case of Booth's multiplication method, we follow something different procedure. Why is the different? Now come, see, when there is a, what I told in case of hardware multiplication method, when there is a string of 1, each time a 1 is encountered in the multiplier bit, we need to add the multiplicand with the partial product, with the partial result. Again, there is a 1, so we need to add this multiplicand with the partial result. When there is again 1, we need to add multiplicand with partial result. So that many times we are having a string of 1, multiplicand need to be added with the partial product to get the final result. In case of Booth's multiplication, it is giving us the idea that when there is a string of 1, we will consider the first 1th position and the last 1's position. These two positions we are bothering about. Where is the first one? Let us suppose this number 14. So where is the first one and where is the last one? In some other way, let us come to the point. Suppose the number is 14. Plus 14 is a number that is selected as the multiplier. So we need to multiply a multiplicand M with 14. So we need to multiply M with 14. We need to multiply M with 14. Now, this 14, what is the binary of this 14? The binary of this 14 is here. This 14 need to be represented in 2's power form. Can we represent 14 in 2's power form? Yes, we can represent. How? 14 may be written as 16 minus 2. So 14 may be written as 16 minus 2. What is 16? 16 is, 16 means we know it is 2 to the power 4. What is 2? 2 means we know it is 2 to the power 1. So when there is a string of 1, the string of 1 is, this is the position 0. What is this position? This is the position 0. This is the position 1. This is the position 2. This is the position 3, this is the position 4, this is the position 5, and this is the position 3. So these are the positions.
So one is starting from position 1 to ending at position 3. In the opposite way, we can say from 3 to 1, we have a string of 1. So in the left direction, we are saying that from 3 to 1, we are having a string of 1. That is said that the from B to A, 2 to the power K to 2 to the power M, K that is in the left hand side and M that is in the right hand side. So M means what? M means we are having 1th position. K means what? K means we are having 3th position. So from the right hand side, if I say that from 1th position to 3th position, we have a string of 1. So may I write 14 as 2 to the power 4 minus 2 to the power 1? You agreed that 2 to the power 4 minus 2 to the power 1? What is 4? Can I write 4 as k plus 1? Instead of writing it 4, may I write 4 as k plus 1? May I write 4 as k plus A plus 1, because 3 is k, so 4 means 3 plus 1. So may I write 2 to the power 1 instead of writing 2 to the power 1? May I write it 2 to the power m? Yes. So general sense, in a general sense, 14 can be represented as 2 to the power k plus 1 minus 2 to the power m. 14 can be represented as 2 to the power k plus 1 minus 2 to the power m. Where k is 3, that means k plus 1 means 2 to the power 4, minus m is 1 means minus 2 to the power 1. So 2 to the power 4 minus 2 to the power 1. So 16 minus 2, that is equal to 14. The multiplication m into 14, what I want to do, we actually want to do m into 14. So may I do it that m into 16 m into 16 minus m into 2. I'm writing in the right hand side. So m into 16 into m into 2 minus m into 2. May I write? So may I write m into 2 to the power k plus 1 minus m into 2 to the power m? So may I write that m into 14 as m into 16 minus m into 2? So the same thing, may I write that m into 2 to the power 4 minus m into 2 to the power 1? What is the benefit of it? Why I am doing this kind of complex work? This is not at all complex work, because the number we are representing in 2's power. And we know that multiplying a number with 2's power only requires shift operation. You see, when we were having 2, suppose we are having 0, 0, 1, 0. So if I multiply it by 2, what we have? This is 0010 means what? The number is 2. So if I multiply 2 by 2, what is the answer? 4. So what is the binary of 4? The binary of 4 is 0100. So what is the actual operation? Multiplying by 2 means the 1 got left shifted 1 bit. So multiplying by 2, that many time we are multiplying by 2, that many time the 1 will undergo a left shift operation. So we are multiplying in 2 to the power 4. That means the 1 bit will be left shifted, rather the data bit will be left shifted 4 bit or 4 positions. Here also, multiplying the m data by 2 to the power 1 means the data will undergo left shift operation by 1 bit. And doing multiplication by 4 bit, by doing left shift operation by 4 bit, and here we are doing left shift operation by 1 bit, and then the data got subtracted. So what we have done, we have skipped the several time addition operation. And then the complexity of the algorithm becomes very less in compared to earlier algorithms. So this product can be obtained, we have written also, this product can be obtained by shifting binary multiplicand m 4 times to the left and subtracting m by shifting left once. So that is been said that m into 2 to the power 4, then subtracting by m into 2 to the power minus 2 to the power 1. So this is the actual process of Booth's multiplication. Now, as in the multiplication scheme, Booth's algorithm require examination of the multiplier bit. So it will observe the multiplier bit. How? I have said that, see, if we have the string like this, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, let us consider like this. So in case of Booth's multiplication, when there is first one encountered, that is mth position, what we did? M into 2 to the power 1. Rather, minus m into 2 to the power 1. That means from partial product, we are subtracting m by doing a shift operation 1 bit. So this is the position where we are doing something. Why? Because first one encountered. Before that, we encountered a 0. So there must be a logic when we have encountered a first one, note that there was a previous 0. When there are consecutive 2, 1, do we need to bother about anything? No, we are not bothering about anything. That means Booth's multiplication process need to observe the earlier bit and the current bit, both. When there are consecutive 2, 1, do we need to observe? No. But when first 0 is, when a 0 is encountered after a 1, that means previous bit was a 1 and then we have encountered a 0, then what we need to do? We need to do addition operation. Multiplicand will be added with the partial product by doing a left shift operation of k plus 1, 2 to the power k plus 1. When there are two continuous 0, do we need to do anything? Do we need to do anything? No. So when there are two zeros, earlier bit 0, current bit 0, we don't need to bother. When there are 2, 1, earlier bit 1, current bit 1, we don't need to bother. But when there are earlier bit 0, next bit 1, we have something. When there is earlier bit 1 and next bit 0, we have something. What we have? When we have encountered a 0, before that there was a 1, we have to do plus operation. When there is a 1 we encountered and before that we were having a 0, a minus operation will be done. This is the steps is being explained over here. As in all multiplication schemes, Booth's algorithm requires examination of the multiplier bit and shifting of the partial product. Prior to the shifting, the multiplicand may be added or the partial product subtracted from the partial product or left unchanged according to following rules. So what is the following rules? Now the multiplicand is subtracted from the partial product here. The multiplicand is subtracted from the partial product upon encountering the first 0, provided that there was a previous 1. In a string of zeros, here the multiplicand is subtracted from the partial product upon encountering the first least significant 1 in a string of 1s in the multiplier. So encountering first 1 means we have to do subtraction operation. Even if this was also 1, then also we have to undergo the subtraction operation. For that reason, forcefully we will consider a 0 bit. And we will set our hardware architecture so that initially we can set the earlier bit as 1. Because the first bit may be a 1. So upon encountering the first 1, note that there is earlier 0, we will do what? The multiplicand will be subtracted from the partial product. The multiplicand is added to the partial product upon encountering the first 0, provided that there was a previous 1. This case, that it is encountering a first 0, note that there was a previous 1 in a string of zeros in the multiplier. But the partial product will not undergo any change when the multiplier bit is identical to the previous multiplier bit. That means if both the bit are 0, 0 or if both the bit are 1, 1, then there is no change. Only shift operation will be there. See, this is the hardware architecture for the Booth's algorithm. Earlier also in case of hardware algorithm, we learned the hardware schematic. Here we do have BR register. Then we do have complementary and parallel adder. Here is the accumulator register. We have written accumulator. Here we have the QR register. The multiplicand will be stored. Here we will store the multiplier. Multiplier, the position is not there that I can complete the writing. So here I may start from here. Multiplier is stored in keyword register. Multiplicand will be stored in the BR register. Multiplier will be stored in the QR register. This is the QN bit, that means the last bit, that means or 0th bit that we are encountering, and earlier bit. So we have taken one extra flip-flop with name QN plus 1. So this earlier bit, we may take it as QN minus 1 or whatever we want. So this is the earlier bit. That is an extra flip-flop that we intentionally have taken, and initially we will set it to 0. Here is a sequence counter that will keep track of the loop, how many times the algorithm should execute. Now we come to the actual algorithm. This one is one example. Here is the flowchart. So our multiplicand is stored in BR. Multiplier is stored in QR. We have an accumulator register that we are initializing with zero. That we are initializing with zero. That accumulator register will be initialized with zero. How many zero? That many zero. That many digit we are having in the multiplicand. If multiplicand is 5-bit, then accumulator register should be initialized with 50. What will be the size of sequence counter? Depending on the multiplier. If the multiplier is 4-bit, if the multiplier is 4-bit, the sequence counter value will be 4. So, accumulator register value will be set depending on the BR register. QR register, the sequence counter will be set depending on the QR register. So, here AC is equal to 0. We told that QN plus 1 equal to 0. Intentionally, we have set it. SC is equal to N, that means number of bit. Now we need to observe the QN bit and QN plus 1 bit that we did, that we said that we need to observe the QN bit and the earlier bit, that is QN plus 1 we may say, or QN minus 1. So here we are considering QN plus 1. So QN plus 1 bit we are observing. Now if these bits value are 00 or 11, then we don't need to bother anything. What we are doing? Only shift operation. But this shift operation is something different than the earlier shift operation that we learned. The earlier case we learned the logical shift operation. In case of logical shift operation, if we are having our data like 0, 1, 0, 0, suppose we are doing right shift operation, then we did 0, 1, 0, that 0 got lost. And that 0 comes here, there is a vacant position, and that vacant position will be filled up with a 0 in case of logical. In case of arithmetic right shift, we cannot fill up this field by having only a 0 here. Rather, we need to think about what was the earlier bit. What was the earlier bit? The earlier bit was 0. Okay, then I will fill it up by 0. Now, suppose we were having a digit like this, 1010. Suppose we were having this. In case of logical shift, what we have done? In case of logical shift, we put 1 here, 0 here, 1 here, that 0 lost. There is, we are having a vacant position. In case of logical shift, I told you that the vacant position will be filled up by a 0. In case of logical shift right, but actually the micro operation name is SHL, not LSHR. The operation name in SHL means logical shift. Now here what we want to do, arithmetic right shift. In case of arithmetic right shift, if the number was present, that is 1010, that one comes here, that 0 comes here, that 1 comes here, and here we have that 0 lost. Here we have a vacant position, and that vacant position will be filled up with the earlier bit, not 0. What was my earlier bit? Earlier bit was 1. So this vacant position will be filled up by 1 only. Why? Because in case of arithmetic right shift, the sign of the data will not be changed. If it was negative, after shift operation also, it will be negative. If it was positive, after shift operation also, it will remain positive. So depending on that, the leftmost bit the vacant bit will be filled up with data. Remember it, in case of logical right shift, this is only case of for right shift. This is not the case for left shift, because right shift only creates a vacant bit in the most significant position. So in case of logical right shift, the most significant bit position will be filled up with zero. Whatever be the data present, this won't matter in case of logical right shift. But in case of arithmetic right shift, the story is totally different. In case of arithmetic right shift, the most significant bit in which position we have a vacant position, at that particular case, the data that will be filled up in the vacant position is the earlier data bit. If the earlier data bit was zero, the vacant position will be filled up with zero. If the earlier data bit was one, the vacant position data bit will be filled up with one. That means if it was positive, still it will remain positive. If it was negative, still it will remain negative. That means arithmetic right shift deals about the sign of the number, whereas logical right shift least bother about the sign because it is unsigned operation. Arithmetic right shift is a signed operation. So we learned about arithmetic right shift. So in between, now see here, after when both the bit, come to the main point, when both the bit Qn and Qn plus 1 are 0, 0, we are only having the shift operation. And that shift is not an ordinary shift. This is arithmetic right shift. But when it encountered a 1 and 0, that means I told you that in a sequence of 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. So when it is encountering a 0, note that there was a previous 1. In that particular case, when it is encountering, note that there was a previous one, then the multiplicand will be added. That means BR is having multiplicand, so AC is equal to AC plus BR. But if the data bit is 10 like this, that means it has encountered first one, note that there was a previous 0. So in that case, multiplicand will be subtracted from the partial product. That means AC is equal to AC minus BR. So we have AC, that means accumulator. We have AC, that means accumulator is equal to AC minus BR. AC minus BR. Minus BR means AC minus BR. How can we calculate minus BR? How can we calculate minus BR? May I write it like this? AC plus within bracket minus BR. Yes, within bracket minus BR. Now what is minus BR? Minus BR means BR complement plus 1. We know that. So minus BR means BR ones complement, BR ones complement plus 1. That means what? That means BR's twos complement. So may I write it that AC minus BR or AC plus 2's complement of BR that we have written. So AC plus 2's complement of BR. Now this is doing what? AC minus BR. So AC minus BR is doing. And after all three steps, what we need to do? We need to do arithmetic right shift. We need to do arithmetic right shift. Of what? Of AC and QR. The both data, AC and QR. And after doing this right shift operation, the AC will be subtracted by 1. That is AC is equal to AC minus 1. And later on, we'll be verifying what is the value of AC. Has AC reached to 0? If AC reached to 0, what we need to do? Do we need to continue? No, we will come to an end of the operation. If AC is not reaching to 0, what we need to do? Once again, we need to observe the Qn bit and Qn plus 1 bit. So in this way, the operation will continue. And at the last, we will have the resultant in AC and QR register. So this is the Booth's multiplication algorithm. So for now, thank you. In the next class, we will be solving one Booth's algorithm problem. Thank you all.